doctors, and good evening online viewers. Our today's session and topic about ECG. So my dear friends, see here, ECG. What is the full form of ECG? Here the full form of ECG is
electrocardiogram.
Yes, he is absolutely right. Yes, doctor, you are absolutely right again. Electrocardiogram, or we can say graphy. Same thing.
Yeah.
Graphy. Okay. So today I am going to teach you how we interpreted the ECG. Okay. Firstly, I am going to draw a normal ECG. Our today's theme, we are going to know about the normal ECG. Then after that, on our next video, I am going to teach you about some arrhythmias. So here, see the diagram. This one is P wave. After that, Q R. Then this one is T wave. This is P. Okay, I am representing with another color, so it's going to be more easier for you to understand. This one is P. P develops from this half is right atrium, this half is from left atrium. When the right atrium and left atrium contracts, firstly sinus node, it acts on right atrium, then on left atrium, right atrium and left atrium, then it gives a signal to AV node contraction. So this process, the right half P is by right atrium, the left half P is by left atrium, and then conduction goes to AV. So P represent, this one P represent here is atrial depolarization. It's known as atrial depolarization, D-E-P-O-L-A-R-I-Z-A-T-I-O-N. This is known as atrial depolarization, the P waves, and there is atrial repolarization also, but on ECG that one is not visible, that one is not visible. So this one, the next QRS wave, QRS complex. What is, do you understand by QRS complex? This QRS complex represents the ventricular depolarization. This is ventricular depolarization. I will explain you what does it mean. When we know sinus node, then right atrium, left atrium makes P wave, then AV node wave goes, then the bundle of his right bundle branch and left bundle branch, then Purkinje fibers, then right ventricle and left ventricle. So after AV node, that goes to the bundle branch, bundle branches to right bundle branch and left bundle branch. Then it goes to the Purkinje and then right ventricle and left ventricular depolarization occurs. So this is known as the QRS complex, that's why. And after that there is a formation of T wave is formed. Here is a ventricular repolarization. There is a node effect till here. So my dear friends, understand. And from P, beginning of P, from this point till the beginning of Q, this is known as PR interval. This is known as PR, my dear friends, interval. And after that QR complex till here. And ST segment from here till the ending of T wave. From the S wave starting, so known as PR. QRS complex, ST segment. So my dear friend, this is known as the normal electrocardiography. What was the use of electrocardiography, ECG? We are going to diagnose various pathologies by the help of ECG. This is the primary diagnosis, like in case of MI. I am going to explain you arrhythmias, MI, myocardial infarction. We can diagnose by the help of ECG, and after that we need to confirm with markers and so many further investigations, like right bundle branch blocks, left bundle branch block, same. like atrial fibrillation, atrial flutter, ventricular tachycardia, ventricular fibrillations, and so more. What Parkinson White syndrome? I will explain you in my further next coming video. Supraventricular tachycardias, my dear friend, PSVT, proximal supraventricular tachycardias, PSVT, yeah. So many things I am going to explain in my coming lectures. My aim to discuss in this topic how to recognize ECG, what is the normal, and in coming lectures I am going to explain the pathology also. So see, my dear friends, I hope till here you understand very well. First question I am going to ask: how much amount of blood in human body carries? My question goes to Dr. Lal Singh. Please five. Answer. Yes, 5 liter. Yes, 5 liter. A healthy male contains 5 liter, but it varies. Maybe in someone 4.5, maybe in someone 6 liter, maybe in someone, but this is the average one. So my next question, how much percent of blood, total blood of body purify or kidney contains? My question goes to Dr. Madhan. Please answer.
20.
Yeah, 20% is right. A kidney carries a 25% of our total blood volume. Okay. How do you think, my dear friends, in 1 minute, how much our blood purifies? How much blood our heart can purify? Heart can pump in a minute. So how we are going to know cardiac output? Cardiac output equals to heart rate into stroke volume. Okay, I am going to explain in this video how to calculate firstly the heart rate, and then we are going to coming on cardiac output. So my dear friends, now I am going to tell you how to calculate heart rate and what is stroke volume. See, if this is ECG P wave, QRST, T wave, then again P wave, then R wave, then P wave, then T wave, then again PQRS, then P wave, T wave. This is, so we are going to calculate RR interval. RR interval, if here three large box, two, and all are this rhythm. If RR interval is normal, if RR distance is normal, three large boxes, maybe four large boxes in all the three leads. So we are going to take that one, three large box, we are going to divide by 300. So here we are going to find how much the heart rate. It's 100. If heart rate is 100, my question goes to Dr. Emily. Please tell me that heart rate, how we are going to pronounce?
Tachycardia.
Yeah, tachycardia, beat per minute. This is known as tachycardia. So heart rate, normal heart rate includes 60 till 90. Yeah, but above 90 or above 100, more than 100, it's known as tachycardia. Less than 60, it's known as bradycardia, my dear friends, bradycardia. So try to understand how to calculate. If I am giving you example, if one RR interval, here three boxes, here four boxes, incoming RR interval, their boxes includes like three. Okay, let's take, then took all the 3 plus 3, it's 6, and plus 4, it's equals to 10. So we are going to take a mean divided by 2. So here came 5 in medium. No, here 3, so we are going to divide by this in 3. 3.3 something. So we are going to calculate. Okay, I'm going to make it very easy. Let's think. Okay, another. I am going to give a simple example by which you are able to understand. If beat RR interval is irregular, maybe in like atrial fibrillation and so many things. If we think this is 4, this one is 6, and this one we took like here boxes are 4. So 4, 4, 8 equals to 6, and it's known as 14. Now 14 divided by 3, no, we think here 5. Okay, 3 divided by 15, it's equals to 3, 5, 15. Okay, So here total 5 is the mean we are going to take here. If 5 here, 6 here, 4 here plus all 5 plus 6, 11, 11 plus 4, it's 15, 15 divided by 3 equals to 5. So 5 we are going to, these are the large boxes, 5 we are going to divide it by 300. So it's equals to 560 100 is the normal. Okay, another example I am going to give you. This is the another way. Okay, one another. I hope this is so congested, not looking good. So I am going to explain visual of this whole thing. And see, my dear friends, I am going to explain you very easily how to calculate the heart rate. Very easily. See, if our heart rate, we are going to see like RR interval from till here, till here, till here. Here only one box, here two box, here three box. So 1 plus 2 equals to 3, 3 plus 3, 1, 2 it's 3 and 3 it's 6. So 6, total 6 number, how many values we took? 3. So 3 we are going to take here and we are going to divide. So 2 large boxes, if 2 large boxes, then we are going to divide it by 300. 300, these are the RR intervals, there is the large box number. 300 divided by 2, so here heartbeat is 1500, my dear friend, 150 beat per minute. And another also, if we are going, these are the large box, in one large box there is 1 2 3 4 5, these are the five values in large box. From here 1 2 3 4 5 5. If we took a small box, so small box like we took like 5 small boxes. So if we are going to take 5 small boxes, we are going to divide by 1500. If a small box, if large box, we are going to divide by 300 RR interval. If it's a small box, we are going to divide by 5. So here, if only one box, so here answer is 150 divided by 5. Now 150 is heartbeat came here 300. My mathematics sometimes poor, but not so much. 5 into 15 is 3 and 2 zeros remaining here. If there is 2 box and we are going to calculate the smaller one, if 2 box here and we are going to do smaller numbers, so smaller number is 10, so we are going to divide it by 10. 10, if we are going to 10, 10, 10 and then 50 is 150. Okay, my dear friends, I hope till here it's clear for you. Claro for you. And I try my best here to explain you. If you have any doubts, please ask me. Ask me, frankly. So now I explained so many things and it's time. I'm going to explain you some more important things about the ECG. About the electrodes. Total 12 leads. 12 leads. So I'm going to explain you. Like RA. RA represent right arm. Right arm, we took some ECG electrode here in the right arm, see here, by this way, right arm, okay. And then left arm, another electrode here, left arm in ECG, left arm. On electrodes, there are visible. In earlier, we are seeing some colors like red color in the right arm, so many things, black color in the right leg, okay. But now everything is written in such a manner, so we have to understand. Then L, left leg, if left leg, it's written like left leg, LL, if right, RL means right leg, RT I am representing here in such a way. And another also, like V1, V2 and V3, like V1, V2, V3, V4, V5 and V6. See, if you have seen ECG like electrodes, like smaller this one, put here, 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 here. I am going to explain you the signs. Okay, V1 we are going to put on fourth intercostal space. See, this is clavicle, after that ribs, and between the ribs there is space. So we are going to take a fourth intercostal space, understand, space between the ribs. So fourth intercostal space we are going to put V1. Fourth intercostal space, right side of sternum. Here is sternum, here is manubrium, then sternum, then xiphoid process. So sternum, fourth intercostal space, right sided, we have to put the V1 lead. And it is between the rib number 4th and rib number 5. Okay, I hope till here understand. Right sided sternum. S-T-E-R-N-U-M, my dear friends. Please be concentrated here. And another V2. V2 is also on 4th intercostal space. Same intercostal space. But the left side of sternum. Left side sternum. This side. One is there here. Another is here on 4th intercostal space. V1, V2 on 4th intercostal space, rib number 4th and between the rib number 5. Okay, then V3, we are going to place between V2 and V4 leads. So now it's very important to understand V4 we are going to put. In V4, we are going to put space between 5th intercostal space. So V3 we are going to put nearly here, little bit between V2 and V4, and V4 we are going to put here. Why? It's a mid clavicular line. V4 in mid clavicular line. Clavicular. I hope, my dear friends, if you ever done ECG by your own, you can see and you can understand. It's very necessary. Sometimes I saw so many people, they don't know where they are putting, but they have lot of experience and they are putting with the help of their experience, and that time this is also correct. I saw, but we have to know mid clavicular region. Okay, V4, then V5 also the 5th intercostal space, but where it's the anterior. This one is anterior, means outside anterior axillary, and between this is mid axillary, and behind it's posterior axillary side. So on 5th V5 we are going to put on anterior axillary line, 5th intercostal space, and V6 in also the 5th intercostal space. Not a great deal, not a great issue, in a mid axillary line. Okay, I hope now you understand the concept of ECG. ECG concept you understand. So I am going to make a one man diagram, and you will, he is in a lying position, man, lying position, his arms, here this is right arm, this is left arm, here it is right leg, here it is left leg. So understand, here we are going to right arm, RA, here we are going to put LA, electrode, here we are going to RL, right leg, electrode, here we are going to put left leg, electrode. And where the V1 and V2 are heart located here, like see, rib number, I will explain you in a black pen. Okay, rib number, clavicle, forgot, rib number 1, rib number 1, rib number 2, rib number 3, rib number 4, rib number 5, rib number 6. So we are going to put intercostal space, 4th intercostal space. So first intercostal, second intercostal, third, fourth. So from sternum here, if we see the sternum here, for this one. So here we are going to, by green I am going to show you. Here V1, 4th intercostal space. Here V2, right side of sternum. And here V3 between V4, V5. And here we are going to put V4, mid clavicular region. And then horizontally, V5 and V6, mid axillary and anterior axillary. I hope till here you have understand it very well. So my dear friends, please try to understand. I really want to explain you and to make you very easy this lecture, because I saw so many videos, but that's are not clear concepts, some videos. So my dear friends, please, I try my best to make it very easy for you, and this video will help you. And another also, I am going to explain the leads. Lead number 1, lead number 2, AVL, AVR, V1, V2, V3 on ECG we are going to see. So how was the meaning? What was the meaning of these? Like lead number, I am going to explain you. Like we have to know inferior lead. Inferior lead, like septal lead, the marker is not working good. Another I am going to use like anterior lead. I am going to explain you why I am going to teach you this, like lateral lead. In further videos you have to know the meaning why. Inferior lead, if we are going to say yes, am I in an inferior lead? So how we are going to know this is inferior? Then septal lead, we are going to say septal defect here. Anterior lead, am I anterior lead ischemia? So how to know by the help of some defects? Okay, like inferior lead, it includes second, third and AVF. This is written on ECG. Septal lead include V1 and V2, anterior lead V3, V4, lateral lead V5, V6 and AVL, and first one lead is remaining. So this, and I'm going to so remember this: inferior lead, second, third and AVF. Septal is V1, V2, anterior is V3, V4, lateral is V5, V6, AVL and 1. So please try to remember. And finally, I am going to explain you the one trick that will help you. This is the normal ECG. Normal ECG, I am going to explain one thing more. What we are going to watch here. If one large box, formula. So, one large box, 300 divided by 1. One large box includes 5 small boxes. If 5 small boxes divided by 1500. So answer here is 300 heartbeat. Here 300 divided by 1 is 300, same. So trick: one large box, 300 heartbeat, two large boxes, 150 heartbeat. How? Then two large box include 10 small boxes, like 10 divided by 1500, answer is 150. Here 300 divided by 2, answer is 150. So my dear friends, it's very easy task. No need to be worried. And what else we are going to watch on normal ECG? If we see what we are going to represent in front of our teachers or in front of exam, how to explain. If I explain in my video, like this is P, this is Q, this is R, this is S, this is T. So, okay, continue. I'm going to continue more another. How to write? Okay, another. I'm going to continue further. See, from here we start. So in ECG, we see firstly our target is P. If P is present, that means P present. We are going to write on ECG like sinus ECG. First thing is very important, sinus. If this is R, this is R. If R interval, their distance between both R is same, then regular. If R interval, same distance, like three large boxes in each, that means regular rhythm. ECG, we are going to sinus. Sinus means P present. If sinus absent means non-sinus, and regular rhythm. So here it is known as regular rhythm. And we can see the T waves. If there is any difficulty, then we are going to calculate PR interval. P from here till the Q starts here. Then PR interval we are going to take divided by 0.04. If I am going to explain you in some further videos also, like PR interval from here, there is a distance between PR interval. This is not a P, this is a T after QRS. So P is here, this one is P wave. So PQ, PR interval. PR interval we are going to, if we see only four small boxes multiplied by 0.04. If the ECG speed is 0.25 millimeter per second, then we are going to take 0.04. in this video. So here PR interval we are going to calculate is 0.16. okay my dear friends. And QRS complex we are going to see narrow or wide. In ECG we have to write everything, and this is normal sinus rhythm. So ECG we are going to say this is normal sinus rhythm. If there is some defect, we have to conclude the diagnosis. where is the defect. But in my next coming videos, I am going to explain everything. So my dear friends, I hope you understand this video, how to interpret ECG and why we use the ECG to identify the MI, acute onset, and ischemia, pulmonary embolism, and so many things we are able to identify ECG, but we need further investigation to confirm the diagnosis. But this is the primary investigation to not to forget ECG. If some patient will came in OPD or in an emergency, if you have a duty, if he complained a chest pain, don't think about acidicity. Yes, it is also a cause of acidicity. Sometimes bone pain, sometimes neurological disorder, sometimes some psychiatric illness, so many things. But firstly, in all the situation, my dear friends, my suggestion, don't forget the ECG. Please do ECG. Do ECG. And if you find any kind of mistake, any kind of arrhythmia, so please try to correct it and call 999 and ambulance and send to the emergency, and you can take the primary management that time. If sinus rhythm, no need to worry. No need to worry. Okay, my dear friends. Have a good day. Thank you. Thank you, my dear friends. Goodbye.